Rick Sanchez has a seemingly unending supply of weird and wacky inventions at his disposal.
I just upgraded our cable package with programming from every conceivable reality.
Looks like something's wrong with the microverse battery. We're gonna have to go inside.
What is my purpose?
You pass butter.
Oh my god.
Yeah, welcome to the club, pal.
But for this video, we're gonna go back to the very first scene of the very first episode of Rick and Morty.
I had to make a bomb, Morty. I had to create a bomb.
What? A bomb?
I'm gonna drop it down there and get a whole fresh start. Nothing but trouble anyways.
Armored neutrino bomb.
Park it right here, Morty, right here on the side of the region road here.
Neutrino bomb armed.
So it seems Drunken Rick's plan was to get everybody on Earth rickety-rickety wrecked, son! And by that, I mean killed. By using a neutrino bomb. But since neutrinos are real particles, how could we make a bomb using them? Neutrinos can only interact with matter via the weak nuclear force. For instance, if a neutrino were to hit a neutron inside the nucleus of an atom, it could turn that neutron into a proton and eject an electron at the same time. It's this electron, a form of ionizing radiation known as beta radiation, which could do damage in your body. And with electrons being so much lighter than any of the nucleons in atoms, it's going to gain most of the energy of that original neutrino. So how much energy for a swifty death? Well, a fatal acute dose of radiation, the sort you'd get from a very intense burst, is at least 4 sieverts. That's 4 joules of energy being deposited per kilogram of mass, or equivalently about 300 joules in total for a human body. With that dosage, it's a 50-50 chance whether you manage to survive within the course of about 30 days. Now, the neutrinos coming from the sun, which are produced in the nuclear fusion reactions in its core, typically have energies up to 400 keV. So for that fatal dose, you'd need 5 quadrillion of those reactions of neutrinos with atomic nuclei per person. The problem is, neutrinos don't really like to react. Yeah, there's a reason why neutrinos are often referred to as ghostly particles. Only about 1 in sextillion, that's 10 to the 21, of the neutrinos coming from the sun actually end up interacting with matter. The rest of them pass through the entirety of planet Earth completely unaffected. So if we need 5 quadrillion reactions in a human body, we are going to need a stupendous number of neutrinos to start with. 10 to the 36 neutrinos per unit area over the course of about a second should be enough to kill you. Then again, Rick's neutrino bomb is supposed to be able to wipe out all life on the planet. That means if I were stood on the other side of the Earth, I still need to get a lethal dose of neutrinos. What that means is we need to up our numbers, because as the neutrinos travel outwards from the bomb, they spread out more and more. A flux of just a squanch over 10 to the 52 neutrinos per meter per second from the bomb should do it. But to put that number into context, that is the same number of neutrinos that the entirety of the sun gives out over the course of 2.5 million years, condensed into just a meter square area in 1 second. But we might be able to make the neutrino bomb work a bit better though. Wubba lubba dub dub! The highest energy neutrino ever detected was 2 peta electron volts. That's some 5 billion times higher in energy than the top solar neutrinos that we've been assuming so far. Now, while these sorts of neutrinos are incredibly rare, we think they come from ultra high energy cosmic rays, which are way more mysterious than even the ordinary cosmic rays whose origins we don't fully understand yet. Assuming Rick's neutrino bomb can produce neutrinos at that incredibly high energy, then that will not only cut down on the number of reactions required for a fatal dose of radiation, it's going to dramatically cut down on the flux of neutrinos that we actually need to put out from the bomb. The reason for that being is that the more energy a neutrino has, the more likely it is to interact with matter. So it turns out that we'd only need 10 billion times the flux of neutrinos that's being put out from the surface of the sun. Not that neutrinos would be your biggest worry if you just happened to be on the surface of the sun. Of course, most reactions which produce neutrinos barely put any of their energy into them. For example, only 3% of all the energy generated by fusion reactions ends up going into neutrinos. So creating a bomb which kills you via neutrinos is just brilliant trolling of the laws of physics. You'd be creating so much energy in reactions and then taking only the tiniest fraction of it to kill people in one of the most inefficient ways imaginable. But of course, it is Rick Sanchez we're talking about. And that's the way the news goes.
Okay, well, sometimes science is more art than science, Morty. A lot of people don't get that.
Thanks so much for watching this Rick and Morty video. I do hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments, what is your favorite invention of Rick's or favorite gadget that's shown up in the series Rick and Morty? And don't forget to like and subscribe my channel for more physics videos on pop culture or whatever's going on right now.